मुगल हिस्ट्री थ्रू क्वेश्चन आंसर्स मॉक क्वेश्चन मुगल हिस्ट्री एंड शेरशाह सूरी पार्ट थ्री शेरशाह सूरी प्लीज वॉच द प्रीवियस वीडियोस इन विच डिस्कस द हिस्ट्री ऑफ बाबर एंड हुमायूं दिस वीडियो इज अबाउट शेरशाह सूरी क्वेश्चन नंबर वन विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स आर करेक्ट फर्स्ट ओरिजिनल नेम ऑफ शेरशाह सूरी वॉज शेरगान Second, in Battle of Kannauj, Shershah Suri defeated Humayun and founded Suri dynasty. Third, Delhi was the capital of Suri Empire. Fourth, in Battle of Chausa, Shershah was defeated by Humayun. The options are A. 2 and 3, B. 1 only, C. 1 and 2, D. 2 only. The first option is original name of Shershah Suri was Shergan. Is it right? No. Original name of Shershah Suri was Farid. Then how did he get the name Shergan? Original name of Shershah Suri was Farid. He was born in 1486. His father was Hasan Khan. His family came to India from Afghanistan. First, he went to Janpur to serve Lodi governor. Then, he entered the service of Bahar Khan Lohani of Bihar. And it is this Bahar Khan Lohani rewarded him with the title Shergan for killing a tiger and saving him. Who rewarded him with the title Shergan? It was Bahar Khan Lohani. Shershah killed a tiger and saved Bahar Khan Lohani. His childhood name or original name was Farid. It was Bahar Khan Lohani rewarded him with the title Shergan. He killed a tiger and saved Bahar Khan Lohani. And this Bahar Khan Lohani rewarded him with the title Shergan. Later he became a member of the Mughal court of Babur. After the governor died, he took control over the Bihar. So, the first option is incorrect. It's wrong. Original name of Shershah Suri was Farid. Then the second one. In Battle of Kannauj, Shershah Suri defeated Humayun and founded Suri dynasty. There were two important battles which became turning point in the life of Shershah Suri. They were in 1539 Battle of Chausa and 1540 Battle of Kannauj. In both the battles, Humayun was defeated by Shershah Suri and Shershah Suri founded the Suri Empire. And in 1555, in Battle of Machhiawara, Humayun recaptured his empire and re-established Mughal Empire. The period from 1540 to 1555 that was under Afghan rule was known as the period of the temporary eclipse of Mughal because during this time, the empire was ruled by Afghans, not by Mughals. After in 1555, Humayun recaptured his empire and re-established Mughal rule. So, this option number second, in Battle of Kannauj, Shershah Suri defeated Humayun and founded Suri dynasty. It is right. And the fourth one, in Battle of Chausa, Shershah was defeated by Humayun. It is wrong. Humayun was defeated by Shershah. In both battles, Humayun was defeated by Shershah. Then the option third, Delhi was the capital of Suri Empire. This is also wrong. Sasaram was the capital of Suri Empire, not Delhi. So, option number one, it was real name, that is Farid. This is right. This is wrong. This is wrong. So, correct answer, two only. Second question. Which of the following statements are correct? First, Sarkars were the ministers of Shershah. Second, Shikhtar and Munsi were military officers under Shershah. Third, Sher Shah followed the principle of local responsibility for local crime. Fourth, the options are A, 1, 2, 3 and 4, B, 3 and 4, C, 2 and 3, D, 1 and 4. Sher Shah was a great administrator. He left his imprint in architecture, administration and economy. And these questions are related to his administration. The first one is, Sarkars were the ministers of Sher Shah. This is wrong. What is Sarkar according to Sher Shah administration? Sher Shah divided his empire into several provinces called Sarkars. Sarkars means it's a province, division of his empire. And the Sarkars were further divided into Parganas. Parganas again into Mahals, Mahals again into Maudyas, then into villages, which are known as Dehis. So this is important. Sarkars are the division of his empire into provinces and Sarkars are further divided into Parganas. Sarkars were not the ministers of Sher Shah. Sarkar means a province. His kingdom was divided into provinces and these provinces are called as Sarkars. It was further divided into Parganas. So the statement first, wrong. Second one, Shikhtar and Munsif were military officers under Sher Shah. Sher Shah empire was divided into 47 Sarkars. Each Sarkar was further divided into various Parganas and in charge of various officers. And Shikhtar was military officer who looked law and order. But Munsif was officer who collected land revenue. It was not military officer. Munsif collected the land revenue in the Pargana. Shikhtar was military officer, but Munsifs were the officers who were collecting land revenue. They were not military officers. Statement second, wrong. And Fordar means treasurer and Karkun means accountants under Sher Shah rule. Ikhtas were various administrative units. Now, Sher Shah followed the principles of local responsibility for local crime. This is correct. Fourth, Mukkidam was responsible for the controlling local crime. Mukkidam means headman of village, head of village. So, this is also correct. Sher Shah followed the principles of local responsibility for local crime. It's true. And Mukkidam or village headman was responsible for the controlling law. Local crime. Mukkidam were punished for failure to find culprits. So, the answer is 3 and 4. B. The answer is B. Ministers under Sher Shah. Diwan I. Wazarat, Finance Minister. Diwan I. Aris, Military Department. Diwan I. Rasalat, Foreign Ministers. Question number 3. Which of the following statements are correct? First, Raja Todarmal was a contemporary of Sher Shah. Second, Secondary Gaja was made the base for the measurement of land under Sher Shah land revenue system. Third, farmers were allowed to make revenue payment directly to the government treasury under Sher Shah rule. Fourth, Sher Shah introduced the system of Kabuliyat. Options are A, 1, 2, 3 and 4, B, 2 and 4, C, 1, 3 and 4, D, 2 only. Who was Raja Todarmal? He was the finance minister of the Mughal Empire during Akbar reign. He was one of the Navaratnas in Akbar court. Was he a contemporary of Sher Shah? Yes. He served under the administration of Sher Shah Suri in management of land and revenues. He made accurate survey of agricultural land and fixed a definite revenue for each unit. Raja Todarmal worked under Sher Shah administration in management of land revenue system. This is correct statement. Secondary Gaja was made the base for the measurement of land under Sher Shah land revenue system. This is also true. Sikandar Gej was introduced by Sikandar Lodi, and Shershah Suri also made it base for the measurements of land. So the statement second is correct. Farmers were allowed to make revenue payment directly to the government treasury under Shershah rule. This is also true, so that the taxpayers are saved from any exploitation by the middle officers. He saved Indian farmers from the exploitation by the middle officers like Zamindars and money lenders. So, farmers were allowed to make revenue payment directly to the government treasury under Shershah rule. This is also correct. Shershah introduced the system of Kabuliyat. This is also correct. He introduced the system of Kabuliyat and Patta. Kabuliyat means deed of agreement with peasants. Under Patta system, the area sown, types of crops cultivated, and revenue share was duly written on paper. So, the statement 4 also correct. First correct, second, third, fourth. Four statements are correct. So, the answer is A. Question number 4. Which of the following statements are correct? First, Shershah Suri introduced the national highway concept for the first time in India. Second, Shershah Suri introduced a regular postal service and attempted the standardization of weight and measures. 3. Hindi poet Abdul Fazl completed his Padmavat during his reign. 4. Shershah introduced new silver coin called Dam. The rupee coin of the Shershah became the basis of later British currency. Options are A 1, 2 and 4, B 1, 2, 3 and 4, C 2, 3 and 4, D 1, 3 and 4. First question. Shershah introduced first time the national highway concept in India. This is true. Shershah Suri made many roads to increase trade. He developed the communication by laying four important highways. First went Sonargan to Sindh, Agra to Burhanapur, Jodhpur to Chittoor, Lahore to Multan. He constructed the Grand Trunk Road from Sohargan to Attock. That means near Calcutta to near Amritsar. Now the Grand Trunk Road is known as Shershah Suri Mark. It is also called as a long walk. And its part from Delhi to Amritsar is National Highway 1. So option first is correct. Now Shershah Suri introduced a regular postal service and attempted the standardization of weight and measures. This is also correct statement. He introduced a regular postal service for communication and attempted the standardization of weight and measures. Third, Hindi poet Abdul Fazl completed his Padmavat during his reign. This is wrong. It was not Abdul Fazl, but Malik Muhammad Jaisi completed Padmavat. So this is wrong. Fourth one, Shershah introduced new silver coin called Dam. This is correct. The rupee coins of the Shershah became the basis of later British currency. This is also correct. So statement first is correct. Second correct, third wrong, fourth correct. 1, 2, 4. Answer A. In architecture, he completed the work of Purana Kila. He built Guni Davasa, Sharemandal Library. Note this point also. Guni Davasa and Sharemandal Library was built by Shershah and he completed the work of Purana Kila, which was started by Humayun. In next video, we will discuss about other Mughal rulers. Thank you. Share and subscribe.